Hi, Bookish Besties. My name is Brittany. This is Rescues and Reads. Thank you so much for joining me here today. If you are new, welcome. I'm so glad you're here. And if you are already subscribed, as always, I appreciate your continued support. Thank you for returning to another video. Today, we are here to talk about book buying habits. So if you have been with my channel for any length of time, you will probably know that roughly in about 2021 that I started to make a very conscientious and concerted effort to change my book buying habits. And so I thought that I would just come on here and do this very casual, informal, chit-chatty style video talking about how I approach book buying these days, the why of it, and also kind of touch upon some of the impracticality and unsustainability of our current book haul culture, especially as it relates to buying new books as opposed to used books. Now, as a caveat, as a disclaimer, I am in no way, shape, or form attempting to shame or judge anyone who continues to do large book hauls of unread books. I personally love to watch large book hauls on BookTube. It is certainly a guilty pleasure of mine. I'm living vicariously through anybody who's doing these large book hauls. And while I certainly crave that big, huge rush of dopamine I get when I bring new books into my home, I also do take some time to think about the repercussions and consequences of these large book hauls. And so that's kind of what I want to talk about here today. And I'm particularly referring to book hauls full of mostly unread books. I'm not really talking about book hauls where you're bringing in books that you might have read through your library and you want to own physically on your shelves. That's not particularly what I'm talking about, although doing that with new books is also part of the conversation we're going to have here today. Now, I have told this story many times on my channel, but just in case you are new or you have missed it, in order to provide some context as to where this is coming from, I used to be a voracious reader as a child. I would consume books constantly, but once I got older and I started to be distracted by life things, you know, dating and working full time and going to school, I really didn't prioritize reading anymore. In fact, it felt impossible for me to sit down and physically read a book when I was spending most of my day absorbed in textbooks for school. And so I really didn't read anything for pleasure for many, many years. And then when I finally graduated in 2017, I started reading for pleasure again. And it was also around that time when I discovered BookTube and the online Bookish community, which I had no idea existed prior to that time. And I also discovered websites like Book Outlet. And as you can imagine, my Bookish world absolutely exploded. At this point, I would have considered myself a new reader because I didn't really know what my reading tastes were now as an adult and as somebody who hadn't read for pleasure in a really long time. So I would purchase books that just sounded the slightest bit interesting to me. And then what ended up happening is I had this influx of books go onto my physical TBR. And as time went on, as I started to really hone and curate my tastes as a reader, I started to lose interest in a lot of the books that were on my physical TBR shelves. And it came to a point where I was starting to unhaul a large amount of books that I hadn't read. And ultimately, that is just wasteful. Even if I end up donating those books or selling those books on Pango and giving them a new home and a second life, which is what I always try to do with anything that I'm decluttering, not just books. I try to avoid throwing away or recycling when I can. I always try to give them a second life. But regardless of that, there is still an element of waste involved in this process, whether it is the waste of money that I may have spent on the book, or whether it was the time and mental energy I spent regarding the book, thinking about reading it, thinking about where I was going to store it, thinking about organizing it, all of that stuff. There is definitely a big element of waste involved when you're getting rid of books that you haven't read yet. And ultimately, that really inspired me to change the way that I buy books. And it wasn't even necessarily because in general, I had a problem with having a large physical TBR. Although I will get to the complications I find with that in just a minute. It was more like I knew that there was no way I could be getting to all of these books in a reasonable amount of time. And the probability of them sitting there on my shelves for years grew with every single book haul, leading to the likelihood that I was probably going to lose interest in a lot of the books that were sitting there on my shelves. But also it was right around this time in 2020 and 2021 that I started to be very concerned and invested in learning more about sustainable living, not just specifically as it concerned the environment, although that was my main priority, but also just as it concerned my wallet and my finances. Now, I'm not going to sit here and do a whole discussion on the environmental consequences of our consumer culture. I think by now we are all pretty much aware of the environmental impact that the way that we consume and discard is affecting our environment. And I am not here to preach to you, and I am certainly not an expert on the topic. There are far more resources out there on the internet that are going to do a much better job about talking about this issue than I could possibly do. I definitely could not do it justice. So if that is something that you are concerned about, if that is something that you are interested in learning more about, I would highly recommend doing your research because that is what I have done. I have done my own research over the past couple of years and just really now fully understand more thoroughly the effects that manufacturing and logistics have on our environment. From the sourcing of raw materials to the creation of the product to logistics, getting it to the stores and getting it into the hands of consumers. And then of course, not the very least of which ends up in the waste when we're getting to the end life cycle of the product or when we just no longer want that product anymore. I don't think it's any surprise to anyone that the the way that we produce waste in this world is completely unsustainable and causes a huge amount of environmental degradation. So a lot of these concerns are things that I take into account when I'm not just buying books, but I'm buying absolutely anything. This is something that's important to me, and it's something that I want to take into consideration. But also from my perspective, doing large book hauls of unread books is unsustainable from a practicality standpoint as well, because in reality, I know that I'm never going to be able to get to all of the books that I have on my shelves. In theory, if I'm bringing books into my home that I have not read yet, I legitimately want to read them. And if I'm bringing in dozens, maybe even hundreds of unread books into my home on a yearly basis, what are the odds that I'm actually going to feasibly be able to get to all of those books in my lifetime? Because if we're being realistic, I'm probably not going to stop bringing in new books into my home. So for example, let's go ahead and break this down into numbers. Say for example, I'm starting clean. I have absolutely no books on my physical TBR. And in the year 2022, I purchased 150 books, none of which I read during that year. Let's say I typically read 100 books. Let's make it a nice round, even 100 books. And in 2023, I do nothing but read from my physical TBR. That means by the end of 2023, I still have a surplus of 50 books going into 2024. But more likely, I am not just reading books from my physical TBR, and I'm probably also not preventing myself from bringing in new books. So let's say, again, at the end of 2022, I have 150 unread books on my physical TBR. In 2023, I read 50 books from my physical TBR, leaving 100 physical books on my TBR. But also on top of that, I bring in 100 new books in 2023, and none of those I've read. That means that going into 2024, if I'm doing the math correctly, I have roughly about 200 unread books on my physical TBR. And that number is just going to keep growing and growing and growing, and the problem is going to keep compounding if I don't change my book buying habits. And that is what ultimately makes it unsustainable. Because if I'm consistently bringing in more books than I can read in a year, and I'm not focusing solely on reading books on my physical TBR, and I'm compounding the problem by continuously bringing in more and more books that I haven't read, that number is just going to continue to grow. And I'm never going to be able to actually get it under control, no matter how hard I try, because ultimately the root of the problem, my book buying habits, is still going to be exactly the same. So that's really what inspired me to start looking at my book buying habits a little bit differently and start changing the way that I approached book buying. Now, I will say that the real pinnacle of change that occurred for me, what really helped me change my mindset when it came to book buying and helped me change my book buying habits, was that I had to get out of the scarcity mindset. I realized that I didn't need to own absolutely every single book that I wanted to read. Those books were still going to be there and available to me when I was ready to read them. I didn't need to worry about actually owning the books right this minute in order to ensure that I was going to be able to read them, especially if I knew that I wasn't going to be getting to them anytime soon. And also in the meantime, I can continue to keep track of the books that I want to read through other mediums like Goodreads or a spreadsheet or adding them to my Amazon wishlist. I did not need to have a physical reminder of all of the books that I wanted to read, and I didn't need to own them out of fear that they weren't going to be around. And that's really what helped me, are those two things, getting out of the scarcity mindset and realizing that I didn't need to own all of the books that I wanted to read just for the sake of tracking the books that I wanted to read, if that makes sense. I really started to ask myself, when going to make a large book order, how would I be served by making this purchase knowing that I'm likely not going to get to these books anytime soon, rather than waiting to purchase them until I actually wanted to read them? And the answer is that I wasn't going to be served much at all. Will I get that initial dopamine hit when I place the order? Absolutely. But that dopamine hit will fade, and then I will ultimately be left with all of these books that I have to figure out what I'm going to do with. I'm now going to have to figure out how I'm going to house and store and organize these books. I'm going to have to figure out when I'm going to read them. Now these books are not only taking up space on my physical TBR, but they are now taking up space in my mental load as well. Because any single time I added a book to my physical TBR, I also feel like I added something to my to-do list, right? That physical book became something that I had to do regardless of whether it was now or in the future. And I don't know about you, but I do not want to add anything unnecessarily to my to-do list. And so again, all of this really kind of came together and really made me change my perspective on book buying and how I approached book buying going forward. And so what I really started to focus on was only bringing books into my home that I had either read in some form, maybe via my library or Everrand, because through both I can get audiobooks and ebooks, or B, waiting to purchase a book until I was actually ready to read them. Now, of course, there are definitely few exceptions to this rule, and there are a few exceptions that I've allowed for myself. First, y'all know that I have a Book of the Month subscription. I've had a Book of the Month subscription for many, many years now, and I don't see myself canceling it anytime soon. I absolutely love their service. I appreciate it a lot, but almost every single one of those books that comes into me are going to be books that I haven't read. So those are going to be added to my physical TBR shelf. But again, in those instances, what I've made is a pact to myself to make those priority reads and to get to them as soon as I possibly can. And of course, I'm also a Fairy Loot subscriber. And with Fairy Loot, not only do you not get to choose the book that you receive, but oftentimes you don't even know what the book is before you receive it. So in that instance, I kind of have to make the decision once I receive the book, whether or not I'm going to read it. But again, that is another instance of a book coming into my home that I haven't read. And it's a book that I'm going to have to try to make a priority at some point. If you couldn't tell, one of my major goals when it comes to book buying is to read books as I purchase them or as close close to when I purchase them as possible because I do not want them lingering on my physical TBR. So all of the books that are coming in from Book of the Month, from Fairy Loot, from my Facebook gifting group, and also the special editions that I might purchase as well, because y'all know that I love a pretty book. I'm absolutely a sucker for it. And if there is a book on my TBR that I really, really want to read, and I see that Fairy Loot or Illumicrae or Litjoy is going to release a very special edition of the book, I am likely to snag it because that is the one instance where that book really won't be around if I wait to purchase it, if that makes sense. That is the one instance when the scarcity mindset really kicks in and I absolutely have to have that special edition. But it's only those four instances when I'm really bringing in books into my home that I haven't read. And for the most part, I'm trying to read those books as soon as absolutely possible. I'm trying to make it so those go onto my physical TBR, but then immediately come off of my physical TBR. And again, another big goal of mine for 2024 is to make sure that I'm reading the books that I've hauled in 2024 in a prompt manner. I think last year I did something like 70% of reading the books that I've hauled. And this year I really want to try to be above 80%, maybe even 90% if I can manage it. That is how dedicated I am to reading unread books that come into my home in 2024. And that is part of the larger effort that I have to make sure that my book purchases are made mindfully and with intention. And also as part of that, not only am I trying to read the majority of books in 2024 that I haul in 2024, but I am also going forward not allowing myself to unhaul a book with the exception of the Fairy Loot books that I don't have a choice in. I'm not allowing myself to unhaul a book that I haven't at least attempted to read. So every single book that I haul in 2024 going forward, I have to at least attempt that book. If I DNF it, I'm allowed to unhaul it. But if I haven't picked up the book yet, I absolutely have to read it and give it a try before I allow myself to unhaul it. Again, the whole point of this is to really make sure that I'm purchasing books with mindfulness and attention. And really, that's what I think some of the larger book hauls of unread books lack, is intention. And that's what I want to curate in my own book buying habits. That is the influence that I want to have on my BookTube channel. And that's really why I've been working hard to make myself accountable this year with like the balancing of the book series that I'm now doing in my reading roundup and some of those 2024 goals that I mentioned earlier. And of course, I'm also trying to read more books that I'm hauling. I'm trying to read more books from my physical TBR that I'm actually bringing in and adding to it, which again is where the balancing of the books comes in. Because no matter what, I want to make sure that my physical TBR is not growing. I want to get as close to zero unread books on my shelves as I possibly can. Now, if having a large physical TBR doesn't bother you, then by all means, continue to do what works for you. You do you. Again, I am not here to judge or shame anybody who loves to do large book hauls and who loves having a large unread TBR on their shelves. I'm just trying to give a different perspective to book buying and potentially help people who may want to cull their physical TBR and who maybe has had a really hard time doing that in the past. Because I know that we're not going to stop bringing in those new and shiny books. We're always going to be distracted by the shiny new things, the shiny new releases that we're super excited for. And sometimes we're always going to prioritize them over the books that have been sitting on my shelf. But I'm trying to find a way to balance that distraction with the shiny while also making the books on my physical TBR a priority. I wanted to let you all know that I feel and understand the struggle and I'm trying to actively win the battle. I don't want to keep the status quo. I want to make sure that I'm conscientiously changing these book buying habits so that my physical TBR doesn't get out of control and it doesn't get overwhelming. And that's very much the direction from which I'm approaching my book buying going forward. And that definitely means, you know, not snagging up a bunch of books just because they might be on sale, or just snagging up a book that sounds really, really hyped, knowing that you might not get to it immediately, or just snagging up any book at all that sounds even remotely interesting to you without having a genuine excitement for it. I know that there have been plenty of times, and I think I've talked about this in the past, where I have picked up a book that sounded kind of interesting, but yet part of my gut instinct was saying, I don't know if this is really your thing, and I don't know if you're actually going to ever be in the mood to read that book. And sure enough, months or years down the road, I end up unhauling that book. I should have listened to that gut instinct. So unless there's just this true enthusiasm for a book that I'm bringing into my home, unless I know with 100% certainty that I absolutely want to read this book, come hell or high water, no matter what, I am just not bringing it into my home. If there's even a little bit of trepidation about the book, I would much rather read it from my library or from Everrand rather than bring it into my home first and then ultimately having to unhaul it later. All right, everyone. Well, I think that's really the majority of what I wanted to say in this video. This was meant to be a very informal, chit-chatty style video. I didn't really have a solid organizational plan of what I wanted to touch upon. So I'm very interested to hear from you. What are your current book buying habits like? Do you love having a large TBR to choose from? Do you end up unhauling a lot of books that you haven't read yet if they've been on your shelves for a long period of time? Are you trying to perhaps change your book buying habits or limit your physical TBR? If you're looking for some accountability, I can absolutely be that for you because I certainly understand the struggle. Again, I'm just trying to bring a different viewpoint to book hauling. So please comment down below and give me all the tea on book buying. Or if you made it to the end of this video and you are not feeling chatty, go ahead and leave me a dollar sign emoji in honor of the book haul topic that we are talking about today. And as always, if you like this video or if you just like me, please be sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I post 2 videos a week on Wednesdays and Sundays, and I would love to connect with you in any of those future videos or on any of my other social media platforms, which I always leave linked down below along with the books that I might talk about in a video. Until next time, y'all. Bye.